Hello everyone, welcome back. I hope you watched our previous video on biomolecules and aldol. Thank you for viewing, liking my videos. If you have not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel so that you can keep enjoying more and more chapters on chemistry. Our today's topic is types of covalent bonds. This is from the chapter Chemical Bonding and Molecular Structure from class 11. First of all, let us understand the meaning of what is a covalent bond. A covalent bond is basically a bond formed by sharing of electrons. It is a bond which is formed by sharing of electrons. And how many electrons are you going to share? You're going to share 2 electrons. We've also studied about what is an ionic bond in our previous classes, which is a bond formed by loss of electron from one side and acceptance of electron from other side. Whereas here, we're not going to lose anything or gain anything, but we're going to share the electrons. So basically, there are 2 types of such covalent bonds. The first one is a sigma bond, which is symbolized as sigma. The second bond is pi bond, symbolized as pi. Let us first understand the basic difference between a sigma bond and a pi bond. By taking the example of a simple atom like carbon, atomic number is 6, its electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. So the valence shell of carbon is number 2. So n is equal to 2. And if carbon has to make bonds with itself or with any other atom, it will have to use its valence orbitals to make bonds. So the valence orbitals over here are s orbital and the p orbital. So carbon can make 4 bonds at the most. It cannot make more than 4 bonds. So the first bond which it is going to make is going to be a sigma bond. Remember that. So the sigma bond is the first, generally it is the first bond which is formed. And after that, if an atom can make more bonds, like carbon can make, hydrogen cannot make, oxygen can make. So only those atoms which can make more bonds, first they will go for a sigma bond and then they will be going for a pi bond. First they'll make a strong bond, then they'll go for a weaker bond. So here we see now what is a sigma bond. A sigma bond is that kind of overlap which is done along the internuclear axis, which is called as a head-on overlap. Now, internuclear axis essentially means Z axis. Okay, by convention, what is the internuclear axis? We must understand is the Z axis. So a sigma bond can be formed by the orbitals S or P. Purely P also, they can form the sigma bond. Let us take simple examples now. So these kind of figures you're going to draw in the exam if they ask you to show the various kinds of sigma bond which can be formed. So we have got here 2 s orbitals. Everyone knows that they are spherically symmetrical. They don't have any directional character. The electron density is distributed evenly around. So if 2 such s orbitals, like for example hydrogen atom, if it is bringing its 1s orbital, another hydrogen is also bringing its 1s orbital. Each 1s orbital has got an unpaired electron. Okay, so both the orbitals will overlap. When both these orbitals overlap, the electron density gets concentrated along the internuclear axis in this overlapped zone. So this overlapped zone is called as a sigma bond. Now the hydrogen atoms have changed to hydrogen molecule. So this is going to be a very strong bond, and even if we rotate this bond, it is not going to break. The electron density is situated along the internuclear axis, so it's going to be a perfectly stronger bond. The second overlap can be between s orbital and p orbital. So s orbital can come with its s, you know, spherically symmetrical shape. A p orbital in which we will take only the pz orbital, because the rest two are not the internuclear axis. This is considered as the internuclear axis. So whenever we make a sigma bond with the p orbital, we are always going to take a pz only. Never we will take px or py. So here also the same situation is there. Every orbital brings its unpaired electron and they overlap to a greater extent. So this overlapping zone will be now my sigma bond. So this examples, you can give any example of your choice. From your choice you can give, like, this can be a hydrogen atom which is bringing its 1s orbital. This can be a fluorine atom which is bringing its 2pz orbital, which is the valence orbital. Both overlap and we get a formation of hydrogen fluoride molecule. Now if these hydrogen atom and the fluorine atom go on rotating along the axis, nothing is going to happen. These electron density, this electron density remains as it was in the beginning. So the bond is never going to break. It's a very strong bond. In the case of P-P overlap, we will be taking the PX, we can take PX orbital or we can take the PY orbital also. Similarly here I can take PX or PY. Now what happens is, the why are we taking in this manner? Because we have to take PX, PX, because they have to be parallel to each other. They, in the case of, okay, now here we are not going to make pi bond, we are going to take sigma bond, sorry. So we will not take PX, PY, we will be taking only the PZ, PZ. So this is our PZ. Same way it has got one electron here, this has got another electron here. Take example of any atom, like carbon atoms will be making a sigma bond in this manner. So this will be the zone of electron density, that's your sigma bond. So remember that whenever a sigma bond we are going to make using a p orbital, it has to be essentially a pz orbital and not the px or py. So these are the three types of sigma bonds, three types of overlaps. The pi bond now is going to be the bond which is formed by the lateral overlap or the sideways overlap. It is also kind of covalent bond because it is formed by sharing of electrons. So here we can take the px, px orbitals which will be overlapping with each other, or py, py orbitals which will be overlapping with each other. So right now I'm going to take px, and it can be 2px, 2px if I'm talking about carbon atom, for example. Carbon is making the double bond over here. So both the orbitals will be having one unpaired electron each, and there will be a lateral overlap or the sideways overlap. So this zone of electron density is above and below also, okay. So this is the pi bond, and it is not a very effective overlapping, so it's a weak bond. So these are the two nuclei. So the electron density is above and below the internuclear axis. Since the extent of overlap is very less, the pi bond is a comparatively weak bond. And if the atoms start rotating, then definitely this overlap will be destroyed and the bond will break. So there is a restricted rotation in this case. The pi bonds cannot move, unlike sigma bonds which are always going to move. So this was your pi bond. Let's take a quick look at what are the differences between a sigma bond and a pi bond. This question will be for 2 marks in the exam. So you must attempt this question very nicely. The first point is that a sigma bond is formed by head-on overlap or overlap along the internuclear axis, whereas a pi bond is formed by sideways or lateral overlap. It's a strong bond, whereas this is a weak bond. So if this can be a give reason question, why is it a strong bond? Because the extent of overlap is very high, whereas the extent of overlap is poor over here. Rotation around the sigma bond is possible because it is along the internuclear axis and it's a good overlap. Whereas here it's a restricted rotation, which means that if you try to rotate the atoms, the bond will break. Okay, this kind of restricted rotation gives rise to a phenomenon which is called as isomerism, which you will study ahead in the chapters. So it is, the restricted rotation is the cause of isomerism, that is geometrical isomerism, cis and trans. Then the electron density here is going to be very much high along the internuclear axis. So it is going to be concentrated along the between the two nuclei along the internuclear axis. Whereas here the electron density is going to be, you know, rotating continuously above and below the axis. The various possibilities of overlaps is SS, SPZ and PZ, PZ. We have seen this. Whereas here it will be between the PX, PX and PY, PY. So that was all about this video. And I hope you have understood what is a sigma and a pi bond. If you want to, if you've got some personal requests, you can always send me that. Keep watching my videos and subscribe to the channel. The next video would be made on hybridization, which is again an important concept for standard 12th also. Thank you. Take care.